Today, I'm going to show you the top 10 SwiftUI one-liners that will blow your mind. Seriously, only one-liners that take your SwiftUI project to the next level. Let me know down in the comments below how many new ones did I introduce to you. Now, let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. And if you are as excited about learning SwiftUI as I am, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one 16-minute Zoom call if you have a bug in your code or if you want to learn about SwiftUI or iOS in general. Go ahead and check out. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, let's get into the code. I have prepared here a little small dummy project for our examples. It's just a simple content view from the vanilla Xcode template, and I added some stuff, a few state variables, and you will see all of them in action in this video. Go ahead and make sure that you find out all of my 10 one-liners, and then we have our tab view. Inside the tab view, we have our navigation stack and then a vertical stack, and all the way down we have some padding, navigation title, and image of the house, a system name, image, house for the tab item. Let me just build and run so we can see what we basically have is just a simple navigation stack with some views in them. Now, the first one is alignment to the leading. Now, usually, and Apple also recommends this, if you want to align a text, for example, to the leading part of your device, then you should just add a horizontal stack, use a spacer for that. But there's an easy way of doing this. Well, it is involving some frames. So let's just have a frame. And right over here in those two parentheses, I'm going to type out max width. And I'm just going to choose infinity and then a comma. And also we have the option of alignment. And then I'm going to either choose trailing, leading, or whatever. I'm going to use leading. This is what I want. And let's build and run. And now you will see that the leading text is actually on the leading part of our view. How awesome is that? Just a one liner, really amazing. Now, what does this do under the hood? Well, the frame sets its max width, so if the frame of the text will have the frame available as the whole width on our device. And then, of course, the alignment is leading. Next up is the date formatting inside the text. This is really, really amazing. So currently I just have here now, but I want to format it much better than just have a now right over here. So let's grab our current date. By the way, any date will do. I'm just using current date to be much easier. So then I have a formatter. So just start formatted. And then you can just have a date and time. Also, you can have formatted, and I'm just going to choose this one because this is not well known. And I'm just going to have date time. So let's just have date time, and then maybe just have a weekday. And the format for the weekday, let's just have this maybe white. You can experiment here, whatever you'd like. And then let's have also an hour and a minute. Why not? And of course, all of them can be formatted forward. So this is really, really powerful. Now we have Sunday 4:42 p.m. Yes, this is the time that I'm recording this video. Okay, so that's how we can format the date inside a text. Really, really nice. Next up is to toggle the boldness of our text, which is really cool. This has been just introduced, so let's check it out. Before I get into the code, let me just show you that we have a state variable that is bind to this toggle, so we can just toggle the text of is a bold. Okay, so what I want to have here is a bold, and now you can see we have two initializers, one with the simple bold, you already know this most probably, and then we have the one with an is active. So we want to say is bold, so we just add in that state variable. Let's build and run. And now if I toggle, you will see that the title of this toggle is just changed to is bold. It's really, really nice. Now it's bold, now it's not. Great. So that's how you can toggle the boldness. This also applies for italic style. Okay, next up, number 4, is better spacing. So let me just show you how this looks like currently. So we can see that we have this color of orange. We are inside the horizontal stack, but clearly here the padding is much smaller than on the leading part. And that's because the spacer by default takes up a little bit of space, a default space. So what to do? Well, what we want to do is in the spacer, we want to have a minimum length. And that minimum length, well, in our case, I want to set it to 0. And now if I build and run, you will see that the color of orange will take up as much space as it can, but it's still kind of pushed to the trailing part, to the left, to the right of our screen. This is what you should use if you are using this kind of trick to use the spacer to push things around inside the horizontal stack or a vertical stack. Next up, number 5 is vertical axis on the text field. This is really awesome. Let me just show you what we have currently right over here. And what I'm going to do is just type in some text here with the autocomplete. And as you can see, it's just having only one line. Now, prior to this, we didn't have this kind of multiple line adjustment for the text field on its height. So now this axis is a really, really nice addition to SwiftUI 4. And all I want to have is the axis of vertical. Now let's see how this text field behaves. It's going to be really nice. So let's just have this. Oh, by the way, we don't have any space right over here. So let's just remove some stuff. So like that, and maybe even the button. Let's build and run again. And oh yeah, it was the orange at fault. Let's just build and run again. Yeah, because it's just squashing that text field. We don't really need that. Okay, so now if I just add in a lot of words, see what's going on right over here? It's just adding another height to another row in that height of our text field. It's really, really great. Okay, awesome. Next up, let me just uncomment these back. There we go. Next up on the list, it's number 6, presentation details on the sheet, or also presentation drag indicator. So if I just take a look at, well, I have to build and run again because now we just commented that in. If I want to present this sheet, so show sheet, it's just a sheet, it's a regular one. Most probably you know how to do this already. It just has a binding of is presented and I'm toggling it on the button tab. Now this sheet, I want to make it really, really nice. So first of all, I want to add some presentation details. If you didn't know this, now you have presentation details. For example, we have medium and we can also have dot large. So let's see how this looks like. Now, this is kind of a bottom sheet, so-called. So let's just go right over here. Really nice. If I tap on the drag indicator, it's just going to jump up to the large one. Also, if I just swipe down, you will see it's just swiping to the medium and then it's just swiping away. Really, really great. Also, we can remove this presentation drag indicator if we want to. So let's just go presentation drag indicator. Let's just set the visibility to hidden. By default, if we have medium and large, so there are multiple presentation details, it will be shown. But now I'm just removing it. And now I don't have anything to tap on, so I have to drag all the way up or down to have those nice animation. It's really, really cool. Now, one thing to note here, you don't have to have only these default medium or a large. You can just go and have a custom one. So let's just have a fraction or a height. Let's just go with a height fraction. You know, you can just have like 0.5% of your screen's height. For this, let's just go with 200 maybe for the height. It's super, super flexible. I really, really like it. Amazing. Okay, so next up on the list is number 7, how to hide the tab bar. So if I just, let me just move this out of the way. If I just click on destination with hidden tab bar, this button, I'm just going to navigate away, but as you can see, the tab bar still shows. So how can I remove this tab bar? Well, it's really, really easy. What I want to do is inside the destination view, so on my text right over here, I want to have dot toolbar, so toolbar. And I want to set the visibility for, visibility is set to hidden for dot and tab bar. So let's just build and run, and now the toolbar of the tab bar toolbar will be hidden once we go to that destination. So let's just click on destination with hidden tab bar. As you can see, the tab bar is nowhere to be seen. It's really, really amazing. Okay, next up, number 8, add a drop shadow. Now, adding drop shadow was quite hard before, but now you can do it really, really easy. So let's just grab the circle and add a fill. And we're just going to have a style right over here, maybe dot red and shadow. And right over here, I'm going to use a shadow with a style. You can just choose a color and radius. That's kind of the easiest way of doing this. But let's just choose the one with the style. And then I can have either a drop shadow or an inner shadow. So let's just go with the drop shadow. You can just use also inner shadow. And yeah, you can just go, let's just go with the color also. So let's just choose a color right over here. And that would be maybe black. And then let's have a radius, because that's of course needed. And then I think that's going to be really, really great. So now this circle is filled with red, and it also has a drop shadow of black with the radius of 10. Really, really great. Gradient text. So gradients, this is something new. It's really, really awesome to have. I have this gradient text. It's a font large title and font weight black, so we can really, really see this text. And I'm going to add a gradient to it. So how do we have that? Well, we're going to use something called the foreground style. This is new in iOS 16, SwiftUI 4, and it's super, super powerful for the foreground styling of your views. So let's just have this foreground style. I'm going to go with the style again. So it's the most complicated one. And then I'm going to add a linear gradient. And for that, I'm going to use the colors start point and end point. You can just go ahead and choose all of these if you wish to. Now for the colors, I'm going to add maybe two colors. Let's just have maybe dot yellow and dot blue. Let's just type out that one, blue. And the start point, I want to set it to the leading, and the end point to the our trailing. Of course, you can just customize this to your needs. Let's see how this looks like. Okay, and there we go. We have a nice gradient from yellow to blue. Of course, this looks ugly and you shouldn't use these two colors, but now you can have the power of gradients, which is really, really great. And finally, we have a number 10, generating a random color. So let's just type out color right over here. And I'm going to use the one with the red, green, and blue. I don't care about the opacity because, yeah, that would, you can just do that. So on the red, green, and blue, I'm going to actually have a random between 0 and 1. So let's just add in here dot and then random in. And here we are going to have a range 0, and let's have 3 dots right over here and 1. And the same goes for the green and blue. So let me just paste that in there. Let's just build and run, and then we are going to have a random color. There we go, random color. Build and run again. Again, we are going to have a random color. I believe if I just change the view right over here, yes. You see, because it's just loading it over and over again, the view will be generating a new random color each time I change something on the state. This is really great for testing purposes, so you don't get bored with the default colors. Now, if you did like these 10 one-liners in SwiftUI, I highly recommend that you check out how you can make money with SwiftUI. Most importantly, with iMessage apps. Go ahead and check out the video, it's right over here.